Can I tell him about the bird? Alright, let's go. Actually, wait. Oh my god, her brain.
I bet it's not easy for me.
What's another firework?
Ooh, another firework.
Are we just giving ourselves more of this gunpowder?
Pile of black powder.
Well, I'm finding
Ooh,
these.
Another firework.
I'm finding these things all over the place.
Wrap that in some paper and light it, and you'll get a pretty decent explosion.
So I got more and more gunpowder.
I should let her keep working on her paint, even if I don't think she has a...
Gotta look for more gunpowder.
I'll just leave it there. The plates are covered in grease, especially.
Another one.
Ooh, another firework.
Ooh.
Wrap that in some paper and lock.
Ooh.
Ooh, another firework.
Is it getting bigger?
Wrap that in some paper. Another firework. That's enough black powder for a stick of dynamite. Almost.
Wow, really? We need that belt. That's not gonna work.
The wooden board is about 4 gnome steps long. I'm 1 gnome step, 2 small feet, and a big thumb in height. I'm not enough. I could easily reach the V-belt with the rope, but I couldn't get it down. It's hanging over some kind of hook.
Oh, we need to destroy that hook somehow. Combine the gunpowder with the poster. Oh!
So, let's see. If I roll the gunpowder from the fireworks up in the poster, I'll have a stick of dynamite.
Wow.
Homemade dynamite. Although, I will need more black powder.
Alright, we're gonna find more fireworks then. Oh, come on.
I wonder where the pipe comes from. Maybe some. Hey, Nate. Time for work.
Yep, I just came by to harass you, tell you to get to work. Can you help my friend?
Hi, Ethel.
There's someone who would really appreciate your talent for alchemy.
I met someone who needs help. Your help, to be exact.
Oh, someone else here.
Some kind of burning question he needs to ask. I don't have any answers. Only more questions.
He is a she, and it's about an alchemy problem. She wants to mix up a, fluffy pink paint.
Understood. That's doable.
Really?
Doable? Then can you show her how to do it?
Mm-hmm, yes. Monsieur de Demar always said we should help others.
Except zombies.
Where is she?
So, there's a little problem.
There might be a little problem.
A little problem? What?
She's just an itsy-bitsy teeny-weeny little problem.
Tinsy-tiny little problem? Who is she?
That is, a secret.
That's, Secret. You know, mum's the word. All secretive in that. I could tell you, but then I'd have to kill you.
Secret?
Yes. You have to wear a blindfold and a clothes peg on your nose.
Ah, they're smelly.
Then how am I meant to mix the chemicals? I have to see how they react and smell, whether the correct concentration has been obtained. No, no blindfold, no clothes pegs.
She's a zombie.
She's, vivocationally challenged?
Vivocationally?
Well, no, I mean, how should I put this? She's, a zombie.
You wanted to take me into the monster's cave?
They're not monsters. Their names are Gulliver and Esther, and they don't want to hurt you. Well, we should probably stay away from Gulliver at the moment.
I'm not doing that. No chance.
No surprise. Are you sure you don't want to help the zombies?
The zombies want to leave their caves. Isn't that a good reason for you to help them?
I'd like the caves to be zombie-free, believe me. But I'm not going anywhere near those monsters. Cost me a leg last time. Whew.
Isn't there any way?
Well, maybe, when pigs can fly.
Yeah.
Monsieur Demar asks me, of course. I'll do anything for Monsieur de Dumas.
He would ask you to help them, for sure.
But he hasn't, and he isn't here.
Are you going to help the zombies do some alchemy? Please, pretty please, with sprinkles on top.
Will you help Esther mix up the fluffy paint? Please?
No. Well, only if Monsieur de Dumas asks me.
Or when pigs fly. Somehow I have to convince Ethel that Remi wants her to help the zombies. Either that, or I need a pig and a pair of really big wings. It was nice to have met you, Ethel.
Knew you already. You lay in Timmy's bed for days. Why? Wasn't your fault what happened to the Archmage?
You think? Imagine if a few rats were to die because it turned out that, in reality, you couldn't cook. How would you feel?
Not good. I'd blame myself. Would feel stupid. But Monsieur de Dumas requests your assistance. You can't leave him in the lurch.
I tried to help last time too, and it ended in disaster. Who can say that it won't happen again?
Questions, questions, tricky questions.
I don't think Ethel would be thrilled if I just took the candle.
Ask her for it.
I don't think... Maybe if I'm very careful... Ouch!
I've got eyes back there too. Not really, but I...
Sorry.
Hey, Timmy.
Hi, Timmy.
Hi.
I've met a robot and a zombie.
Ethel believes there's monsters down there, but they're only zombies and robots as far as I can see. They seem to be very nice.
The skull throws things at us when he sees us. The little robot runs away if I get too close.
Maybe I can get them to be more friendly towards you.
You sound so enthusiastic. You're a bit worried about Remi, aren't you?
Nothing will happen to Remi. He's the toughest rat I know.
He's all alone down there in that terrible hole.
Maybe. It's not all that terrible.
No one has ever dared to go down there. Apart from Uncle Remi and his grandfather. That hole is evil. I wish I could have gone down there with him.
Ethel seems to be a bit special, don't you think?
Ethel's an excellent cook, but a little special, isn't she?
Totally crazy.
I might have expressed that a little differently.
Her cage in the lab was just above the cauldron. Too many fumes. But she's harmless, and the best alchemist around.
Do you know how to get out of these caves?
I know this isn't what you want to hear, but you know any way out of these caves?
Dozens.
Even one in my size?
Nope.
No. apart from the unreachable hole in the ceiling, of course.
That's exactly what I was afraid of. Timmy?
Timmy? How about a little more understanding?
I know you're mad at me, but how about a little more understanding?
Well, he's mad at him.
Imagine finding out that you're not a mage, even though you never wanted to be anything else. Imagine that you're so incompetent that your friends are killed and it's your fault.
No one got killed.
But we need you here. The resistance is getting weaker, and Vampyorin's getting stronger every day. And you're going to abandon us anyway?
No.
How am I supposed to help you? I'm not a mage. I'm not a fighter. I'm not a healer. I'm not an engineer. I'm nothing. Even the Archmage was powerless against that wand. What do you think someone like me could do?
Could at least try.
I could really do with your help.
I could use your help, Timmy.
And?
It's about the zombies. I can't manage it alone.
I'm supposed to help people who throw things at me. What do you get out of it? They're going to help you out of here so you can just run off?
They need help. Bill is exploiting them.
You know Bill, the merchant? He smuggled them into the city and lowered them into this hole. Now they have to slave away for him down here to pay off their debt.
He's exploiting them. They should just stop working for him.
They can't just stop. He's got them trapped.
And once they stop working, what do you think will happen then? They're stuck here underground, without any gold, without any way out. What are they supposed to do? Live off society's waste like... well, like you.
It's not a bad life. At least, it wasn't until we started being turned into hamsters. Some of us have even been forced to wear dresses and hats. Can you imagine?
Come on, are you man or mouse?
So, Timmy, man or mouse?
Rat. One of those rats trying to save what can still be saved. The others are all out there in the streets fighting.
If everyone is out there fighting, why are you sitting here?
Really? If all the rats are out there risking their tails, so why aren't you with them then?
I'd be out there in a flash. But Uncle Remi asked me to stay here. And I listen to what my uncle says.
Ask yourself, what would Remi do?
One question. What would your Uncle Remi do?
Right now? He would climb down that black hole to find a way to destroy the one that's transforming the world.
And that's what he did. I really need help, Timmy.
The zombies need our help, Timmy.
Why should I help the zombies?
You know Bill, the merchant, he smuggled them into the city.
He's exploiting them.
Innocents who've been treated unjustly, right in front of your eyes.
The zombies haven't done anything to anyone. All they want is a better life for themselves. And their son.
I'm not saying that I think it's right what Bill is doing to them.
But you won't do anything about it. Aren't you the one who said you should help others whenever you can? Here's your chance. Right here. Right now.
And coincidentally, we create a way for you to get out of here, right? But at least you want to help the zombies. That's a step in the right direction.
Don't count on me taking any more steps in any direction.
That remains to be seen. Friends?
Friends.
Friends.
Okay, I'll help you and the zombies. And then we'll see.
Well, if he gets out of here, he can help everybody. So we've got a little Remi, a little Timmy.
I'm glad Timmy's with me. He reminds me of how I used to be. Optimistic, fearless, naive.
And fed up.
Hey, Timmy, have a look at this feather.
What about it?
Maybe we can use it somehow.
If I had a hat, I'd look just like Remi.
Huh. We could show him the cloak also. Oh, we gave him the cloak, I guess.
I have a little cape here, Timmy.
And what are you going to do with it?
Esther isn't able to mix the fluffy pink paint alone. She needs Ethel's help. But Ethel won't help her unless Remi asks her to.
Uncle Remi always gives his orders face to face. And I think even Ethel would realise you aren't Uncle Remi.
Exactly. That's why I thought of you.
A disguise. But my voice is much too high-pitched.
I could do the talking for you.
That sounds like a plan that simply can't fail.
And is bound to be extremely entertaining.
Perfect. The hat looks almost exactly like Remy's. Put the disguise on to me.
Here, why?
Put the disguise on to me.
He says, here, why? But we can't hear him. Okay, now put the disguise on to me.
Let's see how good the disguise is. Yeah, sure. Try your luck.
Look who's back, Ethel.
Ish me, Remi. Monsieur de Damas.
So where is Monsieur de Damas? You trying to pull my leg? There's nothing wrong with my eyes. You boys.
Oh well.
I'm glad Timmy's with me. Here.
Let's see how good the disguise is.
You mean we really go through it again?
Try your luck.
Look who's back, Ethel. Ish me.
Sorry, guys.
So where is... There's not you, boys.
Do we need the feather in it? Will that really make all...
touch it.
With the tape?
How should I touch it?
The tape. Okay, never mind.
Hey, Kate. Time for work. I'm sure Timmy could get that thing off the hook.
Right,
there has to be a safer way to get the little guy up there. Or a more spectacular one. Either would work.
Huh. Can we attach this to him? No.
I could easily reach the V-belt with the rope, but I couldn't get it down. It's hanging over some kind of hook.
Well, what you do is you attach it and then have Remi run up the rope. I don't know. Introduce Timmy and Nate to each other.
Nate! This is Timmy.
That's cute.
Hello. Together, we'll make sure that you can get the final delivery ready for Bill, okay?
Dig dog.
He said, I'm honored. At least, I think that's what he said.
We seem to understand everything else he says.
I'm sure Timmy could get the hat.
Alright, let's go up here. See if we can do anything.
The nice thing about the bell, Bill can't ignore me. If he doesn't respond, I'll wake up half the town and people will ask questions.
See if we can get him to work with the zombies, maybe.
What do you want?
Out. I'm helping the zombies in producing the slates.
I'm helping Gulliver, Esther, and Nate produce the slates.
Rats and zombies. You've got strange friends, Weathervane.
Gulliver says you helped them too.
If he says so. They were desperate to get into town. I charged them a pretty penny for it.
Gulliver slaves away day and night to pay off what he owes you.
Yes, I have to admit he's doing much better than expected. Still, I could have sold more slates if he was quicker.
How many... He only has so many hours in a day, guy. As soon as the zombies have completed the last delivery, are you going to let them go?
Gulliver says the next delivery will have paid his debts. Will you really let them go, then?
Wilbur, a sea stone merchant always keeps his word.
Yeah, Bill. sure.
All right, maybe not, but I will pull them out of there. The magic slate market's collapsed. Prices have hit rock bottom.
Huh.
I'm switching over to water, bread, and fast horses. There's a mint to be made on them right now.
Right then, we'll get the delivery ready, and you pull the zombies up. And me with them, tucked away in a bag somewhere.
What did you say?
Nothing. Gulliver is hoping to work for you in the upper town, that's what I said.
Gulliver's hoping to get a better job with you once he's finished the delivery.
How's he gonna do that? Does he want to live here in a little townhouse with wife and child?
Sure.
He's a zombie!
Actually, I think he wants to live in a palace. There are a few problems with the last delivery.
There are a few problems with the last delivery.
Yes, tell me about it. That Van Buren's only prepared to pay a pittance, even though we're talking about a very special and limited edition.
Those special requests are the problem. I hope you're paying Gulliver a little extra for them.
Probably not.
Weren't you listening? I'm getting less gold per slate. Before my profit margin shrinks, he'll have to do without his gold. We all have to make sacrifices in this financial crisis.
As always, a truly informative conversation. See you later.
You're welcome. I don't mind risking life and limb for our cozy little chats.
I'm sure you don't.
Not overdo it.
Alright, what else? Is that more? Another firework.
Ooh, another firework.
I still need a few loads of black powder. Once I have enough, I can use it to make a proper stick of dynamite.
Well, here's more fireworks. And why are we finding all these fireworks all of a sudden?
Ooh, another firework.
Do you have enough yet?
I still need a few loads.
Nope.
Hey, Nate. Time for work. Bill has a rope up there. He'll let it down as soon as we finish the last delivery. At least, that's what he says. It's the best chance I've got.
Well, I actually know where to get the coal from. In the dark cave.